Welcome everyone, this is Commissar Rycor, and this is how to build a Macharius Vanquisher super heavy battle tank. And this is what it looks like when it's completed. This is actually tank number one. I will be doing this build. I'll be doing the video on tank number two. So, let's get into it. This is pretty much the parts that you get when you get the Vanquisher model in. Let's see if I can move that. And you'll get the main body of the tank. You'll get the top, which is the, I think they call it the capula. Could be wrong. You get the bottom skid. Now, the one that came before this and this one, they have some sort of an odd bend in them. And so we're going to be having to use some hot water to try to bend that back. And we have the two track pieces. These being the biggest issue that we have trying to remove these. And this, removing this one as well. Now, there was extra ones on here, but I was able, they had small enough little connectors to the sprue material. I was able to just use a pair of snips. Everything in the bag that it comes with pretty much is fine with just a pair of snips. You don't really need a knife, a pair of snips will work just fine. And that should really be all you need for the things in the bag. Now, for these, you can use a handsaw, but I'm going to use a Dremel. So let us move on into the basement and do the Dremeling.
All right. So we got a Dremel here. Now, obviously, you want to keep it unplugged. And your Dremel or your rotary tool might be a little different. No, I don't need to take that off. Take this off. So you're gonna want to lift that. I use these really nice Easy Speed. They got a little bit of a, I don't know, it's a fiber, a little bit of metal around the top, so it keeps them from splintering apart. Because if you use the other normal cutting discs like these ones in here, these tend to, if you kind of flex them by accident, they tend to shatter. So I like to go with these. They're a little bit more, but they're definitely worth it. So we're going to still hold this down. Now, the little wrench that comes in here. So let me pop that wrench out real quick. Normally you can just tighten it down by hand. Depends on really what you're cutting. But normally since, oh, hold on. This is good, there we go, okay. So, now if you're cutting metal or whatever, you definitely want to wrench it down. Cutting, like resin like this, you could hand tight it, should be fine. It all depends on how fast you're gonna spin the tool. So just to be sure, we'll tighten it down. All right, and we'll close it up. Now there are these little bits in here where you could sand some of it down. I might try doing that. All right, so we got our tool. Gonna plug this guy in. So this is the bottom, and right here, I want to get these. So I'm going to put this right on the edge of the table, kind of hold it steady, and then we're going to trim away. Oh, one thing I forgot. You're going to want to use a mask of some sort, dust filter, a little dust mask, because the resin powder that is going to shoot up is definitely a pain on the lungs. So want to cover up, and you obviously want to use some eye protection as well. You know, you don't want to get hit by something. So, and here we go. All right, and we can get the rest of this down with some sandpaper. Now, obviously, this is part of the resin casting where you see a lot of little potholes in here. These we're going to fill in with some green stuff and some liquid green stuff later on if it's exposed. I think that part will be exposed, and we might have a gap because some of these, even flexing them, we might still have a gap. Now, this one's a little annoying, so I suggest going right here. Thank you. And all right. So now you're left with this little piece right here. So, oh, that doesn't, can't really blow on it when you got a mask on. So, but I don't really write about it. I'll just use a brush when I get back up to the office. So. So we got this little bit right here left. Not sure. I'm gonna wipe the camera off just in case it's got some stuff on it. All right. All right, we're gonna use the sanding wheel to sand that further down, but let's continue cutting. Now these are annoying. I don't want to cut up here because I don't want to hit the track, so I'm going to cut down here. All right, and then with this little nub in the middle, just snap it off. So this will allow us to get in there. Now, right here, you're gonna wanna clip that right there. You don't wanna go too deep though, so you just kinda give it an eyeball. So check this side. See, I went a little bit too far in, but not a big deal. Should be able to just snip that off. All right, now this is where it gets a little more difficult and you gotta get really close. So what I like to do is cut some groove lines. This is going to make it a little easier. So, let's see. We can shave a little bit more down. Alright, so we're going to get the rest of this with a grinding wheel, plus we can always clean it up top. We don't want to cut too deep. Now this part is going to get covered with a track, so wouldn't worry too much, but continuing on the next one. Thank you. So you see this channel right here, this little hole right here. So this happened on the other tank as well, and you'll get a little gap right here. Now, a track covers over this, so you don't necessarily need to fill that gap, but if you want to, you can fill the gap. But now we're going to switch over to using the sanding head. So you got that right here, and we can also use this little fine grinder head, but the sanding head should work just fine, so we'll give this a try. Might not be as well. First, I'm gonna unplug the Dremel. Since we used the wrench to tighten it down, we're gonna use the wrench to take it off. And then we loosened it. Tighten it down. Yeah, everything's covered in this resin powder. Be sure to wash your hands when you're done. We'll plug this bad boy back in. All right, and then we'll clean the rest of this up at the hobby table. All right, let's do this one. Right, and that's pretty much all we really need to do here with the Dremel. So make sure you unplug it. And that's pretty much it. I mean, however clean you want to keep your cutting area, it's up to you. I don't really care too much. And all right, so we'll take these and move on back to the desk.
Tired from his evening of preparing the Macharius Vanquisher, the Commissar sets out for food. He scours the lands over and over again, running into obstacle after obstacle. Food eludes him as everything seems to be closed. Yet he knows, great in the distance, about 20 minutes from his home base, there is a place that is always open, and it is where he goes, even now. The Commissar reaches his prize, the mighty Vietnamese foe. So much noodles, so much spice, it is amazing. It reinvigorates the Commissar, allowing him to continue on with the Emperor's tasks. For the Emperor! Back on the road, we find ourselves seeking more items. We are running low on adhesive, and we have asked the Ministratum where we can find more. However, it is becoming more and more difficult. We move our way towards our last bastion of supplies on this day of rest. Ever traveling, the Commissar is ever weary, but he is full, and he is poised to strike.
due to the ecclesiarchy on this backwater planet, there's almost no provisioning shops open on this day of rest. Praise the Emperor, though, that the in-garrison supply depot is in fact open and we are able to acquire what we need to continue with this build. So let's get going. Got what we needed.
Welcome back, everyone. So we're in the office. We're back on the table. We got our pieces in front of us. And we're going to be moving on to the next stage. Now, what we got really going to do here, not really needing to clean this off, just because it started to bother me. We're going to need to sand down all the pieces. This should be pretty sand down. I shouldn't really have to sand this down. This should sit in here just fine. Yeah, this won't really require any sanding. And I don't even glue or magnetize the side in. It's heavy enough to just sit there. And it's easier for, like, if in instance of transportation, if you want to, you just take it off and away we go. So really shouldn't have to sand this that much. Maybe a little bit just to smooth some of these lines down. Now we're gonna be using both our knife for our hobby knife. Now a lot of people use like an X-Acto knife. I actually tend to use this Craftsman box cutter blade. Because these blades are relatively cheap, and they're really sharp, and they're easier to manipulate. I feel like the smaller handle of the X-Acto knife, you could learn how to use a little easier, but with my big mitts right here, I think this is just an easier knife to work with. So this is the kind of knife that I tend to use when I'm doing my cutting work. So, and basically, we're just gonna go through. I'm gonna sand all the pieces down and test fit them through. You're gonna notice that even if I do put this in warm water, I will be able to flex it a little bit. But I'm gonna try to sand it to the point where I can test fit it dry with the bend, because I feel like I can gap fill any part with green stuff a lot better than I can try to bend this into where it's supposed to be. Last time I tried to bend it on the other one, I ended up snapping these two pieces right here, and I don't want to snap those, so I'm gonna try to sand both the main body and the bottom chassis to where they'll fit easier. And I'm going to be sanding and cleaning up these parts basically so the tracks in the bag will fit in these easier. And basically, when we're going to speed up the track, and we'll come back when we're all set up and connected. If anything happens during the time, I'll just slow the video back down and we'll go over it. So let's get into it. Alrighty, so we have sanded down the base to the point where it'll actually just click in. There's a little bit of a gap. Actually, this isn't going backwards, but there's a little bit of a gap on the back and on the sides. Now, the sides are going to be covered up by the track, so I'm not worried about the sides so much. And the tiny little gap that's in the front is most likely going to be covered up by the front. There's a front part that we'll glue on later. So I don't do gap filling until the model is nearing the end, because I only care about filling gaps of where people are going to see it. Or if for some reason that the model won't assemble properly, then I'll fill the gap. So, but what I'm going to be doing now is we're going to be taking these extra track pieces, which go right here, and I'm going to snip these off, and we're going to clean up these parts of the track to fit the track pieces in. And you're not going to get an exact matchup. I might have damaged this a little too much to do that, but I'm pretty much just going to go for as close as possible. There are very few people who are going to really notice the back here. But if you want to get really detailed in, you can actually clip these right here. I normally just shear them straight off, and it'll fit a lot easier. But if you want to be a perfectionist, then, you know, go for it. It's just how I like to do these back rear tracks. But let's get into it. Alright, so I was able to shave it down. There's still going to be a gap right in the side there. And I'll have to determine after it's primed if I'm going to bother with filling it. I think it's a small enough gap to where I'm not so concerned about it. If you were doing this for, say, a master build or a competition, you would be a little less barbaric, so to speak. So I use a gel, I use Loctite Ultra Control, or Ultra Gel Control. It does take a little bit more time to, like, hold down the area. It's not a quick adhesive super glue. It takes a little bit of time to set, so I like to hold, it's set right now, but normally I like to hold on to it for just a little bit. It's annoying for some of the smaller pieces, like the doors where the infantry will slip your heads out of. I don't think I'm going to do that for this model, because I did it with the other one, and I think for this one I want the hatches closed. But normally for doing things that are really small and that are a little heavier than super glue until it sets, that's what I like to use. So that's pretty much what I'm doing right here. And let's move on. Thank you. So, for where we're going to be actually putting the glue on the bottom of the track piece where the base is going to join in with the top, is we're going to run glue along this part, along the inner part of the track, on both sides, and then along the back. And obviously not every area is going to contact the model, but we're trying to get as much contact as possible, so we're going to be running glue along the whole side. I am running a little low in this one. This is my older one. I have the new one that I bought over there. I have another old one, so I'm pretty much going to be trying to use all of what's left in here, and if not, I'm going to have to switch to another bottle. But let's get into it. So we're going to... This is... Now, this glue doesn't dry super fast, which is why I like it. But it does require a little bit of force to get it out of the tube. Yeah, no, this one's spent. Let's see if we got any more left in this one. Alright, this one's working. This one looks more like a new one. There we go. It's like trying to squeeze the shit out of this. You will use a lot of super glue on this model. All right, so we got it all the way around. Now we're going to take the base. Little doors go on the back. And I like to set it in there and sort of hinge it down into place. And then it'll make a little... There we go. That's a nice snug fit. And get it all good. Now, like the old style, I'm not sure if you still have to do this now, but like the old style Tau battle suits, in order to make sure that this doesn't pop back off, it shouldn't pop back off, but just to help it out, we're going to place this down, and then I have, where did I put it? If anybody wants a pillow for, it's basically because I broke my left elbow a while ago, and every once in a while, it gets really sore, so I put a little pillow on my thing, because these armrests on this chair aren't padded. So, I'm going to take an 8-pound weight, or 5-pound weight, or something heavy, but I wouldn't go above 8 pounds. Place it on top, and then carefully place it lengthwise, so you're putting... You're pretty much pressing the top down into the bottom, trying to get that seal to stay nice and tight. And you're gonna want to let this sit for 5-10 minutes. So we're gonna cut here, and we'll come back to after we've done a little bit more prep work with the other pieces. So yep, see you guys in a bit. And we're back. All right. So this had been sitting on there for about 10 minutes. It's definitely on there nice and good. Once I finish gluing on the other bits, then I'll do an overview, and we're gonna probably fill this gap in, definitely fill those air bubbles in. I'm not sure if I have any liquid green stuff, but I definitely have regular green stuff. Liquid green stuff would be pretty good for getting in these little holes, but you can easily use normal green stuff just to kind of patch fill those holes and get those gaps nice and tight. Also, you have to do remember that lore-wise, this is a really fast, hastily built Bane Blade replacement. So a little bit of gaps in the welds kind of does sort of fit to the whole theory and the whole lore behind the tank itself. But what we're going to do now is we're going to glue on the tread pieces. I actually do find that even though resin is a very annoying product to deal with, the fact that the tank is molded in such large, huge pieces, it's a little easier to put together, sort of, than a plastic model. Although I guess having to do all the sanding, you kind of come out to around the same amount of work time. So I'm gonna clean this up a little bit right here. You just notice that. Alright. Alright, so these parts are the front. Nope, that's the other side. Alright. So we'll just make sure we get a nice test fit. I don't have to sand anything else down. Alright, so those will look like they're going to sit in there well. Now, the way you glue these on, you do one of two things. You can put green stuff in along this track bed right here. You can put green stuff in along here, like wet green stuff, and you can squish it in there. And that, along with some super glue, that'll work, because you never really know where, because they kind of mold a little separately. So you might get gaps on the top, or you might get a gap in the bottom. So you're not 100% sure where you're going to get it to be filled properly. Or you could just use as much super glue as you really want. So that's what I'm going to do. And if it doesn't stay, then I'll bust out the green stuff and I'll see what we do. What I like to do is put quite a bit in the center, like make a nice bead line all the way across, and then hit up, you know, put a glob in each one of these corners. So that's what we're going to do. And then we're just going to use a little bit of pressure and let the model sit kind of on that track. And doesn't really require a lot of force, because the track, I like to kind of keep them tight on there anyways. So it doesn't really require a lot of force. And you can kind of like give it a little wiggle to see if it's going to move. If it's not going to move, then you're pretty good. You don't have to really do a lot of manipulation. Kind of just let the glue sit on its own. And then we'll do that side. Now that side's sitting there. And then we're just going to do the next side. Let's do a little quick test fit. Make sure we don't have any issues. Oh, that's a nice snap fit. Might not necessarily. You might not even really have to glue it if you get a good enough test fit and you want to just transport that way. But I kind of think it's easier to transport it with the wheels already on. So, and I don't have to worry about them falling off. Now, you could, if you wanted to, depending on how you were painting it, you could actually paint it with the tracks off if you really cared, but I'm probably just going to paint these all. It won't be an issue. I'm probably just going to spray them all one set color and not really worry. And I can get my brush. I'll get my spray in there, and I'm not really going to be too concerned. Of course, now that I said that, kind of like the idea. Too late. Oh. So. One of those things, put it together and you realize you could have painted it better after you assembled it. This other tube, the thing I bought a third tube. Alright, there we go. A little bit there, a little bit there, a little bit there. There we go. That should be plenty. Now I feel a little bit of little give, which means that the super glue hasn't set yet, because it's not quick dry super glue. So I want to set this down. Now, like we did earlier, I'm going to put cloth over top, and I'm going to put the weight back on to the tracks. Now you got to be careful, because this is going to want to tip. And you're going to want to just kind of leave it against there and let that press that on there. So we'll be back in about 5 to 10 minutes. All right, now that we've waited our 5 to 10 minutes, we're going to take our weight off. Lift our cloth up, and we'll see how she is. Now, even though I waited 5 to 10 minutes, I don't want to, some of the glue might not have completely set yet, so I don't want to try to jerk on it, but it seems pretty stable. I've noticed that either it's my table or it's this model and the same as the other one. They do kind of wobble a little bit. I kind of think it's just the model just wobbles a little bit. It's probably just the way the tracks are sitting, which is fine. A little bit of wobbling ain't no thing. Let's clean off the table a little bit. Yeah. It's just a little bit of kind of the way the treads are flexed, but it's not a big deal. Now, what we're going to be doing next, which it's really up to you what parts you go for next. There's no real instruction set of do this step when it comes to forge board models. They do give you a picture of what things look like, but it's kind of really do it however you want to do it from this point on. Now, what I want to do next is I actually want to build the weapons for the top. This is what we're looking at right now. But to build the weapons, let's dump out our pile of stuff in our bag, and let's do a little bit of sorting. Yeah, I'm going to play a little bit of sorting going on here. So we got our two barrels for our cannon. I want to put those over there. I'm going to put a little canopy right there. This is the front part that's going to cover up these holes on the front of the tank. So let's put that right there. Now these are our drivers. Now I decided that this tank's not going to have, they're going to be closed cabin on this one. So I'm not going to use these, but I'm going to keep these because there's always the possibility that I might get some more Lehman Russes in the future. And there's no reason I couldn't throw these on some Lehman Russes. They're pretty cool looking tank drivers. And yeah, I mean, there's no reason. Plus, I could always throw them onto a Chimera. I've got plenty of Chimeras. Actually, it's a good idea. I could definitely throw these on some Chimeras I got. I don't know if you need an open crew on a Basilisk. I don't think you have one on a Basilisk. But I could definitely throw these on some Chimeras that I have to build up here in a little bit. So I'm going to keep these. Put these off to the side. But I will put the heavy stubber, the little mounted heavy stubber. I will put that on there, so we'll put that over there. A dual mounted heavy stubber right there. These are the side sponsons. These are right here, little side sponson kits. We'll be going for heavy bolter side sponsons like before. Side sponson. This is for that. This goes with that. These two, we want to keep those there. These two exhaust pipes. Those over there. This is the cover grill for the back of the tank. That goes on the back right over here. It's got a lot of flashing material, so you can either leave it on or you can cut it out. I cut it out on the last one, so I'm going to cut it out on this one also. We'll get to that in a little bit. Now this is the part where the barrels attach, so we're going to be needing that right now. Move that over there, and these are some splash guards. We'll put those over there. All right, so what I want to do first before I actually do the gun mounted system, like I said, I'm going to do this a little bit out of order from what I said originally, is I'm going to put this right here to cover up this front part. So let's see if it fits. Whoa. All right, so let's see if it fits right off the bat. Clip that on there. I don't think it's going to fit because the other one didn't fit before either. So let's just take that off. I don't want that to fall if I have to lift the tank. So I don't think it's going to fit right off the bat. No. All right, so let's do a little bit of shaving. Now, this is where you kind of spend a lot of time with just the knife. So, now a lot of people, say, oh, safety first, cut away from you. And maybe I'm just a really bad hobbyist. I always tend to cut towards me, which is why I always end up getting these, I always end up carving the crap out of my thumb. And there's been a few weeks where I've stuck myself so deep in the thumb that I haven't been able to put the models together. But, I feel like if I'm doing this, I'm not getting enough control. I'm just I feel like I'm always just kind of slipping. And this way, I feel like I've got a little bit more meaty control, and I can sort of use my thumb to stop this part, but every once in a while the blade does dig into the finger. So I just kind of get used to feeling that blade up against my finger. Plus, you can always just use the table. And I definitely like this way of... I do this mostly with my plastic models. I just grind it down like this. All right, so let's do a test fit on that. See, these are a little... Oh, no. This part right here is broken off. All right, so I don't think... Now, I could have done this before I put the tracks on, but I didn't. So... So what we're seeing right here is, even though we're getting this happened on the other one too, even though I'm getting the pegs in the hole, I'm still getting some flex. So what I did to solve this on the last one was I cut one of these nubs off. So we'll cut one of these little guides down, so we only have one guide. And then I snip just a little bit extra off each side. Just a little bit extra off the side. My original plan was to have some painting studio, I hadn't decided which one, just assemble and paint these for me. Because I was so intimidated by the process of resin and Forge World stuff that I didn't know if I wanted to do it myself. And but I ended up just buying it myself because I went to Warhammer World. Ah, yeah, that fits on way better. Yeah. All right, so we're just going to pop that back off real quick. Throw some super glue on here. How's that record? You like hearing yourself talk? Of course I do. Why wouldn't I? Oh, we're getting near the end of the end of, oh no. We're getting near the end of this tube. I'm running out of super glue. Good thing I still have that one. Yeah. I'm definitely glad I made that trip to the store today. Get that glue. Alright, so we're going to line it up. There we go. Alright, so... And we drop it down, and that... This actually, by sitting it in there, I just covered that gap. So I definitely don't... I don't even have to use gap filler that was in the front, because I covered it up with this. Heh heh! Save me having to deal with green stuff. I hate green stuff, because no matter how many times I manipulate it and use tools and water, it either dries too quick, gets too tacky, or gets fingerprint lines in it. And I've been able to do some stuff with green stuff, but I'm never able to get as good as sculptors do with green stuff. I'm just not as talented. But, all right, so we got that little front part on there. Good. Now we're going to move over to actually doing the turret mounting. So, this... Now, I kind of wish I had a slightly bigger set of snips, but I do kind of like these. So we're just going to... Now, this is going to fly away. I don't know where, though. Boom! Across the room. Cool. Now, it's got a little arrow, which is handy. Tells you which is the top. At least that's what I thought it was. I think it is. I had to look at some reference pictures. All right, going to do another one of these. See how far we can go. Oh, that went backwards. All right. And last one. Oh, that kind of just went straight up. Okay. All right, close the cap and see if we get a little bit more glue out of that one. All right, now cut this flashing material off. Little carving, little whittling. It's just like painting, you know. If you're not really going to see that part of the model, do you really care? No, you don't. Now, I would like to admit that there's not as many mold lines on the smaller pieces than I thought there might be. Now, one other thing I'm not sure if you're aware, is the way glue sticks to a smooth surface. It doesn't really stick to a smooth surface very well. So you kind of want to rough this side up just a little bit. See, I'm trying to smooth out that crack right there, that flashing, that little mold line. But I don't want to smooth it too much because I want the glue to stick to it. All right, now we're going to check to see if we got any more lines. Got a little line right here. We got some lines right here. And this is where the barrels are going to attach. So I'm going to put a little few score marks right here. Help that glue. Help those little micro beads of glue kind of get in there. Score this up just a smidge. So putting these little microscopic score marks. Sorry if my hand was in the way. By putting some microscopic score marks in here, it'll help, you know, the glue just kind of channel in and bead than it would on a straight, smooth, flat surface. Now, not saying the surface was smooth. It definitely wasn't smooth to begin with. But it's just helping out just that extra bit. All right. Let's kind of round that edge off. Because this is supposed to be like, I think it's supposed to be kind of a, I don't know if this is molded metal or if this is supposed to be kind of a cloth type thing. So, all right, and we'll do a quick little test fit. Make sure, yep, fall in the right arrow. So it sits right in there. Cool. Now, we're just going to get some glue on this bad boy. We're going to glue it in. Now, I'm going to put some glue right here and on the sides. Let's see if we can squeeze the last bit out. Squeeze. Oh no, I think we're out. We're out. All right, quick. We gotta toss that one. Grab another one. You know, I thought about buying two. What about one? I only have. We have a few resin models left. All right, so with this, to actually get this to work right from the thing is you're going to have to, you turn it, and it breaks the seal, and then you can use it. So, oh, and it comes out really fast. Oh, God. Oh, God.
We haven't seen any action in months.
Oh, no. We got a glob. We're going to have to clean this off. Oh, no. Put it on there. We get a glob on the side. Oh no. I scored it. I went too early. I'm sorry. I'm gonna try to clean some of that super glue out of that crack. There we go. That'll work. That'll work out. Alright. I got plenty of sandpaper, so. If I sacrifice a little bit, that's not a bad deal. Not a big deal. All right, make sure we're flipping the right direction. Cool. And we'll just slip that in there. Oh, we got a little bit of super glue right here. Now, obviously, if you get it on your fingers, it's going to stick. So you're just going to have to. It's kind of a side effect of dealing with resin. All right, so we're just going to push that on there. And we're just going to kind of hold this in place for a little bit, for a few minutes. Maybe about a minute. I'm just going to kind of hold it. And, yeah, so. We'll come back to once it's set. Be back in a little bit. With the final setting of the glue on this part here, we're gonna take the barrels and we're gonna clean off these barrels. I should have just cleaned the barrels off. Ooh. See, now sometimes when you're moving the knife, you can kind of feel where if you're like, I don't feel right. And just kind of move the blade. Almost felt like I was about to slash my finger pretty tight. Did not want that to happen. Just like Gimli said in Lord of the Rings, don't be hasty. Was it Gimli that said that? Or no? Was it one of the hobbits that said that? Oh man, I haven't watched that movie in a while. Every once in a while I do Lord of the Rings marathons. My fly was unzipped. Your attire is not proper. Alright. Got my Total War Warhammer shirt and again at Warhammer Fest on. Alright. Put a little few score marks in there. Help that glue set up. Alright. Gotta clean this barrel. There shouldn't be too much in the way. Oh, there we go. There we go. Generally, on the barrel, you only find like one line, and most of the time goes down the whole length of the barrel. The problem is,
the problem
with the bottom is sometimes you can't get them flat, so they might, the angle on the gun might be off a little bit. Like, I think my other one, the barrels look a little too close together, kind of like they're pointing towards each other, and not straight. Parallel, like you're supposed to be. Pretty sure parallel is the word in it. But what you can do is you can stick it on a piece of sandpaper and at least flatten it out by going back and forth. Now that'll make it a little flatter, but not too much flatter, which is fine. And then just kind of go through and do that to the other one. Sometimes you'll get parts of resin that are really easy to cut through, and other parts are a lot harder to cut through. So you just want to take it easy, take it slow, don't rush. You know, this is a hobby, it's supposed to be something to calm you down, keep you focused, you know, relax your brain, you know, distract you from your other things that you have to do. It's definitely not supposed to be a rush. At the same time, you don't want to spend too long. It's kind of a duality. All right, so you're trying to clean up, trying to find any big, thick mold lines. We don't have any big mold lines. We do have some cavernous lines, which I think those are going to look fine. They'll give the barrel a kind of a more weathered look. And we'll do the same thing with this one. Just a few back and forth. Kind of straighten that out. Does anybody know if iZombie, the new season's out? I don't remember what. Did I add season one or season two? I can't remember. I don't know why suddenly I thought about iZombie. All right, now with the way the barrels, so you've got this little nub on the bottom. The nub, let me put that on the camera. So this little, there we go. So this little nub right here is actually going to be on the bottom. So that's pretty much all you have to do. Kind of just line them up, and you can put them both on here. Kind of see where. Like, which one? No, these actually kind of look like they're fine. Yeah, I don't really need a... There's a little bit of wobble right there. So let me... You kind of find out where you have to sand it down. And you put them back on there. Okay, that's a lot more straight. It's going to be a better fit. And then you're just pretty much... Kind of making sure that they're on there straight enough to connect. change seating position. Seating position change. All right. Now the stat profile on the Vanquisher is interesting because so the heavy tank is just, it's like strength 8 AP 3, which is the other version. And it's cheaper in points. This one, it's quite a little bit too much. What's the eyebrows combined? There we go. The other one, there's a little line on the bottom that you can line these up. Here we go. Come on. And once you got it where you want it, it kind of doesn't want to move, so you just got to be careful because there's an air bubble in the bottom. And once you, if you move it and break the seal, it's
Kind of like drinking too many beers and then having to go pee. It'll never stop. That should be plenty. And then we're going to do the same with this one. And here we go. Now, it's not going to be perfect. You can get it pretty close.
And then you got your
two barrels. Now, with this, you can just kind of hold them up for a little bit. Just kind of let gravity help with set process for the glue. So I'm just going to hold these. I'm going to find something to rest this up against. Oh, we got a tank right here. Let's just rest it up against the tank. So I'm just going to rest it. I'm going to rest it up against here. And then I'm going to... So what I'm going to do next for the rest of the pieces is I'm going to desprue all the rest of the pieces and accessories that are going to go on here. Which is going to... And I'm going to go through and I'm going to sand them off camera to do a test fit. And so we're going to speed through the rest of the process. It'll be all prepared and ready to go when I turn the camera on next. So see you guys in a little bit. And of course we need a tea break with our Death Cora Krieg mug. Join now. And we're back. So we have cleaned off all the pieces and we have finished our tea. So we're going to be now assembling all the different pieces. I might have to do some tweaking of the parts that I desprued, but we will do that as we're test fitting all the pieces together. So let's take off the top and we'll come to that later. We want to get into here. So the first thing we're going to do is put this little turret on here. Clean that up just a little bit more. All right, now this turret just sits right in here, just sits in that pocket. We're not gonna glue that down at all. We're just gonna leave that right there. And then now this canopy, I did a test fit. This canopy will fit. Now you can put this canopy on before the legs, but I tend to put it on, I put it on afterwards, which requires you to just kind of do a little test fit and make sure it sits right in there. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get our glue. And now we don't have to glue it onto that, so we're just gonna put a little bit of glue. Let's see if I can get this, move this camera over here. Alright, so we're going to put a little bit of glue right here. I don't have to put too much. I'll just smear the, I'm not actually putting anymore, I'm just kind of spreading it around. A little bit there, and a little bit there. And up on this side. So this side with the little lip, you put a little bit on this side. You don't want to put much on this side because it'll get up all in there. And it's not really necessary. This is probably a little bit too, a little overkill on how much glue I use. So let me take some of that glue out of that corner right there. Alright, and then we're going to slide this down into here. Just kind of takes a little bit of maneuvering because you don't want to snap off the tracks that are right here. Come on. Come on. You went in there earlier. It's like the moment you try to do something great is when it doesn't work. There we go. Okay. Aha. All right. There we go. And that, just kind of push that up in there. Kind of mate those up against each other. And that little got that extra splooge, even though I cleaned it. I tried to get it. Let's spread that off there. All right, cool. So now, obviously, that piece in there still moves, which is what we were achieving. Now we take our twin heavy stubber, Now, I've tried bending these back several times, putting them in cold water, and kind of just got to keep playing with them. And you'll get them relatively straight. I don't think you're ever going to be super straight. But we've cleaned out the inside. Oh, so I've cleaned up in here. Spread that out. And then we're going to add a little bit of glue to right there. Not a lot needed on that one. And we're going to stick that right in there. That should stick on relatively easily. Yep. And there we go. So now we have our front mounted heavy stubber and it goes side to side. Excellent. All right, so continuing on with the bottom, we're gonna put these doors on top of the, we're gonna put this hatch on closed. And you can see which side, the side with the extra lip. So we'll just do a quick test fit of both hatch doors. Make sure that they sit on there. Yeah, good. All right. I did notice I had one of these pieces right here was broken off. So I don't know where it is. If it's in the bag. If it even got shipped. So I'm not too angry about it because I got a free tank. So I'm not too worried. But I got a few little chipped pieces here and there. So now we're going to apply a little bit of glue. This time I'm going to put it right on the tank itself, right there, and then a little bit right here, a little bit right there. There we go. And then we will. Now you can tell what side it is because it's got a little tooth on the front. A little indention. Stick that right there. Boom. And then we stick the other. Where'd it go? Oh. Oh, no. Where'd the other door go? Oh, it's right here. There we go. We got those nice and glued down. All right, now we're going to move on to the top. And all we have to do for the top is do the same thing that we just did. And, hold on. We have to attach the gun. So our heavy stubber right here. And our heavy stubber has a handle, which is used to shoot the gun. But I can't tell if it's which. Oh, hold on. I missed this little piece right here. Is a giant pain in the ass. I missed a spot. This wasn't even on the other one, so I didn't even put it on the other tank. But so if it goes on like that, then this wants to be like that, so it's annoying little piece of gun. So what we're gonna do, and even these little let's see, I'm gonna use my knife. There's little portholes in this holder here that have some flashing. Trying to get the flashing off. Some parts of these, some of the tinier pieces, which is probably why I would never buy Forge World Infantry. Like, Deathcore Kree got really nice models, but flashing like this on at least their tanks is annoying. I don't know. I've never had their infantry, so I'm not 100% sure how the Deathcore Kree infantry is, other than the commissars that I have, that I ordered. So, we'll put some glue right there. And then we'll stick this right here. And this one you got to kind of hold just because of the slower drying super glue that I got. Front of the gun is a... And this is another one of those guns that's slightly bent. And has a...
coal that I need to get, Phil. All right. Nope. Not right. Not yet. So we're going to hold that down. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Good. All right. So it's on there relatively straight. The gun is definitely crooked. The barrel is off to the right, but I'm not too concerned about the barrel being a little bit off. Happy little mistakes. I don't like that, though. There we go. Okay, so now we're going to put this piece on. The gun handle. This is so annoying. So there we go. I think this is the top. Or is this the... just the bottom? No, I don't know. This looks like the top to me. If you look at a picture, but whatever. Alright, so I'm going to attach this to the back. It shouldn't really be that. There we go. It's just a light little piece. Someone's like, oh my god, you just put that upside down! I just hope that when I'm actually painting this, that the gun doesn't fall off, because that's going to annoy me. If the gun falls off while I'm painting it, that's just going to be a disaster. Alright, now we're going to put these doors back on, so... or put the doors on, not back on, we're going to put them on for the first time. So we're going to put some glue right there, spread that around. Some glue, put some glue. Alrighty. Now this is gonna go with that part right there. And this one is gonna go on that side. Alright. Oh, I got a little bit of glue on my hands. So my fingers are trying to... here we go. Fingers are trying to keep the metal from sitting down. Oh, I could have.
Alright, there we go. That'll work. That'll work just fine. Alright, so for this back piece right here, this little engine cover, I want to paint the inside of this engine here, so I'm just going to stick that on there. I'm not going to glue that down. I might glue it down in the future, I might not. I'll probably glue them down after I paint the inside, but I want to paint the inside of the engine compartment. Alright, now we get on to the back. We're going to save the sponsons for last, but next part, got our little fuel canister. And this is actually kind of a heavy piece. But it's pretty easy. You just put a little glue on the bottom here and a little bit of glue up there. There we go. Nothing too crazy. And then you just stick it on the back. It's got little guidelines. You just hold it on there for a few minutes. Or a few seconds, actually. Because it'll kind of sit on there on its own. You don't really have to press on it too hard. So we got our fuel tanks. Now these spare tracks... these spare tracks sit like this, and the glue point's on the bottom, so you could put a little glue up top, but it won't necessarily always sit there. There's no exact place where these sit, but you kind of stick them on the back. You're going to put them right on the back here, so that's where I'm going to glue them. Alrighty, so I'm going to put the... put some glue right there. That's quite a bit of glue. So we're going to kind of bring that up. All right. Let me look at the tank here. Okay. All right. Hold on that. Hold that on there for a second. Take this top off. Pretty much just stick it on like that. We'll do the other side. All
we go. Just kind of stick the one on that side. Now the exhaust that we're going to do next, those are pretty easy, but they don't, they're supposed to sit on here and then connect there. They don't really connect perfectly on the bottom, so we're really more focused about putting glue on the backs right here. So, and we're going to put a little bit of glue on the bottom of the exhaust, not too much though. And then we put most of the glue we want to put right here. This is when you'll stick this on here. Go over as far over to the right as you can. Probably could have green stuffed this before, but it's fine. I'm not too worried about it. Do the same to this side. This is definitely not sponsored by Loctite.
Building Warhammer model sponsored by Loctite.
Alrighty. Yeah, you can see right here in the bottom. I'm definitely gonna have to put some. Definitely gonna have to put some putty up in there. There's a gap right here where it just didn't conform. So we're gonna have to put some green stuff all along the bottom tracks right there. Oh yeah, I was like, no, don't fall off. This thing's fine. All right, so let's see, we got mud flaps left. These mud flaps are kind of annoying. So you're gonna flip the tank over. Oh, this is way better without having that door open, because flipping the tank over before when the door was open was a giant pain. So you gotta just kind of line these up, but. They kept falling off last time I was doing this, so I'm going to
just a little bit. You don't gotta put so much on there.
All right. There we go. Ah, see, now they just kind of pop off, even when you're straight up and down. You just do not like staying. Oh, come on. Okay. All right. And then we'll do the other side. I have a Bane blade, a plastic Bane blade. I haven't put that together yet. I don't know if I'm going to do a video on how to put that together since I've never done it. Maybe if I ever have a second Bane blade, I'll do another video. See how popular. No, we need a little bit more on the side. Sometimes more glue is the answer. It's probably. Probably some hobbyist. I don't know if you're like a really good hobbyist. I'm not sure why you're watching this. But an advanced hobbyist is like, oh my god, he's making so many mistakes. All right, so we're gonna set this like this because if I flip it over too early, that's not gonna set right. Now, what we can do is we can attach these boulder heads to these side sponson rounded parts because these headlights will go on last. Headlights were a giant pain. I might actually use my tweezers for the headlights. All right, so as far as these are concerned, you just put some glue on the back, and then you just stick them. They should fit in here if you've sanded it down right. There we go. All right. Pretty simple with the heavy bolters. I don't know. I went with heavy bolters. I could have went with heavy flamers, but I play in a, you know, I don't play in any tournaments or anything. And when I do play, I only play with people that, you know, are my friends. And basically, we don't WYSIWYG at my house. But I guess if I went to a tournament, you know, heavy flamers on a Macharian or Macharius is would be kind of cool, I guess. But I'm gonna either magnetize or just set up my Bane Blade to where it can be all the different variants. Probably won't do a tutorial or anything. Probably just do it. See how it works. I said I was going to magnetize my knight, and I never did. Now, I'm sanding down these parts because they move a little easier if they're sanded down. And I already did sand this one down a little bit, so we just kind of rough it up a smidge. All right, so we can actually attach these upside down. This will go on this side, and this will go on this side. But I want to do a test fit to attach these on here. So I want to do a test fit to make sure that they're going to go on there. Because the first time I did this, he didn't set on there very right. So we'll go. Okay, so this one does sit on there. Now you're going to have to do a lot of pressure because the way they line these, they didn't mold these very well with the. Let me see if I can get this. So these overhang this line, this bolt rivet line right here, and they don't. It would be better if these were a little narrower. So what I found I have to do is I actually have to shave just a little bit off this top and off this bottom to get them to kind of sit a little bit more flush. So these mud flaps, as long as I don't touch them, they should be fine. They shouldn't fall off. So we're going to put that on there. And we take this, slide this into its hidey hole. Now you could, I think you could pretty sure you could magnetize the side sponsons for the heavy flamer, but I don't think you could really magnetize it for the heavy stubber. But if you wanted the heavy flamer and heavy bolter, there's probably enough to be able to magnetize. But yeah, it's kind of just what you do. I don't magnetize much anymore. If I'm just like, hey, I'm taking this, and if someone's like, oh, you can't do that, I'm like, whatever. Well, I'm not playing with you. So once again, I don't play in tournaments. I mostly just assemble. I mean, there was a while where tournaments were a big thing, and then they kind of went away from it. But now it seems like they're kind of coming back to it. So whatever. Maybe they realized they'd sell more models if they had more tournament backing. Alrighty, so there is. You gotta kind of find its home and get it to. So you just wanna. Alright, so the gun will move. Kind of keep moving the gun a little bit. So, alright, so it looks like the side sponson is on there. And as you can see, it's like it's hanging over a little bit down here. Like right here, it's hanging over just a little bit, but it's in the holes. I'm in the hole! So, I'll just leave that on that side. Hopefully it won't fall off. You can take a something a little sturdy like this little piece of ceramic. It used to be used as a water pot. Sometimes I'll put models on top of it, but butt that up right against that. Not to put a lot of pressure, but just to kind of keep it there when we do the other side. Now, unfortunately, I started to shave off these little nublets by accident, so whoops. So I'm not sure if it'll make this easier or make this harder. We're going to slot. Now, you got to make sure you don't put the bolter on upside down. That would make me very sad. Put the bolter in there. Get some super glue. This isn't like welding. Burn it, blood, burn it, drum! Some welder's like, oh my god, what's he talking about? I've only watched people weld, I've never actually welded. Alright. Stick these. See, since I snapped off those nubs, I can't really figure out where the spot is. I think I got it. Looks about right.
Yeah, that looks about right.
We'll just kind of press in on both sides. Yeah, this gun over here doesn't want to move as much. So it's got a really good arc, though. Can move the tanks. The sponsons on these tanks, pretty good arc. Not like the rest I got over there. All right, cool. And now begins the hardest, what I think is one of the hardest parts, is putting these damn front headlights on. Let's take a giant pain in my ass. So I'm going to use these set of tweezers, because couldn't put them on last time with my fingers. And you'd think it would be pretty easy, because they're not, you know, they're not very big. But so we're going to put a little glue right there. A little glue on the bottom. It's good. Because there's a... It looks like a wire. Let's see if I can... So right here, they're going to go right here. And the power point's right there. So we're going to... Trying to line up that connection. Ah, see? You're a giant pain. Get in there. Even when using his fingers. I think in this situation, faster drying super glue would probably be better. Just kind of hold it on there. Nope, not yet. Whew! Okay, hopefully that doesn't fall. Alright, then we do the other side.
We're nearing this finish line, we're almost there.
Okay, a pair of glue. Oh, cool. Ah. Get in there. A tiny little peg. You know, I don't know why, but all of a sudden, I'm suddenly reminded of a vampire anime. I was thinking about Blood Angels earlier, and Sisters of Battle, and how I have a small Blood Angel unit in the other room, but I want a Sisters of Battle army if they ever made them plastic.
But, here we go. All right, put our top on. And there we go, everyone. Just tighten that up. Move that camera back a little bit. We got ourselves. You got yourself a Macharius Vanquisher tank. All right. Awesome. Let me go grab the other one. Oh, I think this one's way better. The barrels on this one are way closer now. I think it did way better on the second try. Sweet. All right, that should be it for the video. Thanks for watching, and hope you guys enjoyed it. If you enjoyed it, you know, hit that thumbs up, put a comment down below. Let me know your experiences with building various Forge World Super Heavy tanks.
But, yeah. I think it turned out pretty well. A little wobbly. This one's definitely less wobbly. A little wobbly. But it's not a big deal. All right. See you guys later. Have a good day.